Here are Hans and Kwaku again. What is the real secret of Kwaku? Why is he still vital and active at age 88, while Hans already has several age-related diseases at age 68? Now, I would be interested in your opinion on this. If lifestyle is the main driver of age-related diseases, is it right to say that it's Hans's own fault? Is he to blame for his unhealthy way of aging? I don't believe that it is Hans's own fault, and I have a thought experiment that I would want to take you through to convince you of this viewpoint. Imagine we would take Hans as a small child from his crib and take little Hans to Ghana. This would of course be a very cruel experiment, so keep in mind it's only a thought experiment. Hans would grow up as a farmer's son, who would work on the land every day, get married, maybe even to four wives, and have a BMI of around 18, glucose levels of around 4, a cholesterol level of around 3, and he would not have the diseases that he has now. We can also do the experiment the other way around. Let us take Kwaku as a small child and bring him to our modern environment. After 25 years of schooling, he will work in an office his entire life, and once retired around 70, he will have cardiovascular disease and probably diabetes. The sad truth is, this last experiment has been done. Many West Africans have been shipped to the United States as slaves in the past, and their descendants now have very similar aging patterns as Hans. This last point also explains why genetics are not the reason that Kwaku is aging in a healthier way. We studied the differences between the African Americans in the United States and the general population in the United States. Remember that the Afro-Americans are mostly from West African descent and have a very similar genetic background as the people we studied in Ghana. Ghana once was the Gold Coast colony, and you can still visit the forts on the coast that were used during the slave trade. In the next graph, you can see the distribution of BMI for people from Ghana in yellow, Afro-Americans from the United States in green, and the general population of the United States in blue. Now note that the African Americans have exactly the same distributions of BMI as the general population of the United States. The same holds true for cholesterol and glucose distributions. Genetics, therefore, are not the explanation. The African Americans have very similar genetic backgrounds compared to the Ghanaian people, but have the same environment as the general population in the United States, and thus the same lifestyle, and thus similar aging trajectories. It's my belief that the environment is the main driver of our lifestyle and of the aging process. Therefore, I believe it's not Hans his fault. The same Hans would age radically different in two different environments, even with the same genes. It's the fault of our modern environment. There's a fundamental mismatch between our old genes and our modern environment. The question is not why Kwaku as an individual is so much healthier in old age compared to Hans as an individual. The question is why Kwaku and his friends as a group are so much healthier compared to Hans and his friends. The real secret is that Kwaku and his friends are not in mismatch with the environment, while Hans and his friends are. Watch the next video to learn more about this evolutionary root cause of our unhealthy aging patterns.